It's really the religion of religions.
To those who believe, it's both a church and a lifestyle.
I know that this works.
To critics, it's a money machine and mind-controlling cult.
Saying that they appear brainwashed is putting it mildly.
From the words of a science fiction writer,
they can confront their own problems and solve their own problems.
A controversial church has emerged, and membership is growing.
There's about 10 million around the world.
They are the ABCs of Scientology. Ali, Beck, Cruz. Add to that Travolta and Presley, and Scientology has some major star power. And they're looking for more than a few good recruits right here in Cincinnati.
Through Dianetics.
In the middle of Kenwood Town Center is a display that'll catch your eye. Free stress test. And these days, who isn't stressed?
All right, put your hands in your lap like that. Wrap your fingers around it. Just hold it comfortably still there, okay?
At this retail cart, shoppers are encouraged to try out this so-called e-meter.
When you hold these cans,
yeah,
that tiny energy goes through like this.
Uh-huh.
Your body and comes back and makes a circuit.
The e-meter is a device that's supposed to measure the amount of stress in your life.
Now here's how this works. I ask you a question and you look at it, okay? And as you're looking at it, when this needle moves to the right, that thought, that thing that caused this move, that is something that is stressing you, bothering you.
What shoppers aren't told, this is a recruiting station for the Church of Scientology.
What are these? Hold them. Okay.
We sent in 7 shoppers with hidden cameras, many of them kids, and the Scientologists questioned them about the stress in their lives. This 12-year-old boy is questioned about his family.
Mom? Dad? Is that our dad? Huh? What do you think of our dad? Yeah. You don't like that, do you? You don't know what to do to change it or help with that?
When the Scientologists are told that one of the kids is on Adderall, a drug for attention deficit disorder, this is their response.
No good idea. I check anything. Go on the internet and find what the side effect they have, actually.
Get her off of Adderall and...
Yes. I mean... I don't suggest that I know the take up. I don't know how many years
right.
he's taking or how many months he's taking, you know.
Right.
But you can use this one and you will see the difference, actually.
Bring up the topic of psychiatric drugs and you'll get an earful from Scientologists, including the church's most famous ambassador.
You don't know the history of psychiatry. I do.
The practices that are used by psychiatrists damage people. They harm them.
Well, are you doctors or?
Yes, I'm not a doctor. It's not have to do with medicine or doctor. It's
back
like,
at the mall, the Scientologists are making some strong statements about drugs and the 9/11 hijackers.
Even 9/11
right.
is these guys were on some kind of psychiatric drugs ahead of time. Isn't it interesting that there's a little thing going, well, they were under psychological evaluation.
Right.
Well, if this is working, then why are we having such mess up?
That's not something I've ever heard. That's just somebody's statement of what they think.
I became very fascinated with this particular line of research, and I made it my life's work.
Science fiction writer L. Ron Hubbard is the founding father of Scientology. His 1950 book, Dianetics, is their Bible.
So these are the books, some of the major books that he wrote throughout the years. How to take care of kids and do better with kids. We're not a Christian religion specifically, although some Scientologists are Christians. So it really is fits into our concept. It's more Eastern in tradition of you discover for yourself what is the Supreme Being, and what is that relationship for you?
And now put aside, say,
through classes and counseling, the goal of Scientologists is to reach the point of clear, where stress no longer negatively impacts their lives.
Things that have happened to you in your past do not currently affect your life.
This planet's not run by dogs and cats. It's run by us. We can solve all the problems that we've created.
At the mall, you know? Shoppers aren't told that Dianetics is Scientology.
It's an organization. Oh, the RV organization, we have of course it's a non-profit organization.
Right, okay.
We have our main office in downtown.
Okay.
If you come over there, you can watch that DVD.
We talked with one local recruit who says he initially found Scientology intriguing, until he visited the church headquarters on 4th Street downtown. He says he was pressured to sign up for a class, the same one Tom Cruise first took.
The people going through the Dianetics process were not acting normal, more like brainwashed zombies.
He now believes the church is mostly a money machine designed to rake in cash through classes and counseling. The man says he's been hounded by Scientology recruiters for the past year and called to cancel his interview with us because he's fearful the church will retaliate.
But it has been documented that those that speak out against the Church of Scientology are not merely left alone. Their retribution has ranged from harassment to worse.
That's a very common misperception, and it's just absolutely not true. Recordings of Mr. Hubbard.
Sylvia Standard is a Scientology spokesperson. She's been a church member for 30 years and flew in from Washington, D.C. specifically to respond to our story.
Is this a mind-controlling cult?
Absolutely not. Mind control really involves pain, drugs, hypnosis. It's the kind of thing that psychiatrists do. Scientology does exactly the opposite. Scientology releases you, your inner self. It releases you from problems and upsets that are controlling you.
Church of Scientology, how can I help you?
When we sent a person to the four-story Scientology headquarters downtown, he was asked to watch a DVD about the church.
Your reactive mind is the cause of what's wrong in your life. But with Dianetics, you're going to learn how to get rid of it.
Then says he was pressured to join.
They were putting a lot of pressure. I mean, you should really do this. This will change your life. You have stress in your life. Well, this will alleviate all your stress completely.
Okay. Ijaz Ahmed was born into a Muslim family and says Scientology changed his life. He says he moved to Cincinnati from Pakistan to more deeply explore the teachings of L. Ron Hubbard.
I love being here, and it's been my dream to help people, and that's the only way that I'm in Scientology. It's simple, it works, and you get results.
For critics who hope Scientology disappears from Cincinnati, these renovation plans at their headquarters indicate they're here to stay.
That's just technology.
And at Kenwood Town Center, they found a steady stream of stressed out shoppers.
It's holding you back, right?
Mm-hmm.
And stopping you from being who you want to be. You want to
Scientologists be hoping to find some fellow foot soldiers in their journey to become clear.
Dianetics is the answer.